faces were filled with smile. Our interpreter Sasha, he came and gave us some the Artek kit. Cap is there, then some badges, there the logo of Artek. Then he gave the red scarf. We used to write our messages in this thing. So it was like a very, still I have all these things with me. This is me when I went to Russia, I was like this. This is my friend Mihirin. Her full name was Meharunisa. Then she's from Tajikistan Republic. And she used to write to her mother about me. And her mother used to ask and convey her regards and love to me through letters. Whatever we want to communicate, we'll communicate somehow. So we used to do like this, whatever we want to communicate, we'll use our hands, we'll use our face, something like that. Action language was there. Wherever children are there, the language is of the love. And in Artek, it was the language of love. Children were the most important. As Lenin also told that children should be given first priority in their life. In that time, Soviet Union was going and following Lenin's advice to give children the first priority in whatever they want. And in Artek, I was finding a different world. Because in India, from going a country like India, children were given less priorities in everywhere. But there we were treated like princes and princesses, because they were, you know, so many people were there. They were taking care of our health, they were taking care of our hair, they were taking care of our exercises, and we were they used to take us to bath in the Black Sea. Then food also, every day they will check our weight, every day they will check our temperature, and so much of care was there. They will be saying dobre udre, and some music will be there, so we have to we'll walk up, and then we'll wear the dresses for exercise. We'll go do some exercise in the common place. Then after that, we'll go for breakfast. Breakfast, we have to, one day, one group will make the breakfast. Then from there, we'll go to the common assembly. There we'll take the pledge of the Artek.
Пионеры, берите пример со своих передовых товарищей. Держите крепче руль на учебу, на дружный коллективный труд. Да здравствуют ударники Артека!
Every day we were getting such messages. Some days they used to take us to some factory. Some days they used to take us to some farms. We used to work there. Then we used to organize exhibitions. And some evenings also some gatherings will be there. So I remember when we were there, the Communist Party leader from Chile, Ms. Gladys Marin, came there. Artek was a big thing. It was like a big event. People from many important people. Yuri Gagarin visited Artek, Valentina Tereshkova visited Artek. All the VIPs from all part of the world used to visit Artek and share their experiences and make children aware of the importance of world peace. That was the era of, the Cold War was there, so everybody was thinking about world peace. Peace was the motto of Artek. Artek's idea was to unite the world through children. The best example of globalization of good values. In Artek, we celebrate days. One is for Solidarity Day, one is for Peace Day, like that. And during the Peace Day, they ask us to write letters for world peace. So I wrote in Malayalam, my language. Then all these letters, they will make it in a bottle, tightly packed, and be immersed in the Black Sea. Going to Artek and living in Artek made me totally different. Because wherever I go, I get friends. I have a broader vision of life. I can be positive because I know that world is so big. That after coming back, I thought I should share this, my experience with other children in Kerala. Then I was studying in class 10 and they published the book. Its name was Russia As Seen by Beena, Beena Kanda Russia. This was the first edition. And the book was sold like anything. People, so many people used to write to me. They used to talk to me. They used to come to meet me like that. Then my husband, no? I met my husband also with this book.
Мой адрес не дом и не улица, мой адрес Советский Союз.
I used to write to Mihirin, Olia, Ira, but after the glasnost and perestroika, the communication with Russia and the Russian friends, I don't know what happened, they stopped. It was like, because whatever a country should be there, that things were there. They were hardworking people. They were keeping their time and they were looking after their children. They were looking after their elders. Farmhouses were there. The agriculture was done in a large scale with a mass support. So many things which we dream, country, how a country should be like that. That was there in Soviet Union at that time. After the disintegration of Soviet Union, world lost its balance. In Kerala, we have a legendary king, Maveli. We believe that in his time, such a socialism existed. And our traditional festival, Onam, is also celebrated with his memory. In his place, we used to sing that Maveli Nadu Vaanidum Kala Manushyar Ellarum Onnu Pole. It says that when Maveli ruled the kingdom, everyone was same. I saw this in Soviet Union when I went there. It was the dream of every man, every human being want to be considered alive, have dignity, have integrity, be taken care of. All those things were there. After some years, everything changed. Now Soviet Union is not there. The socialist concepts are shaken. And world is also going through some insecurity because of the fall of Soviet Union. Still, I hope that everything will return and the world will be as we dreamed. Now it is like a myth, but that time, for me, it was a reality of my hopes and dreams.